Hi, it's Dwyer. It's Monday, December the 10th, 2018. Let's, more than a week later, give a post-fight analysis of Deontay Wilder, the WBC heavyweight champion, unbeaten, going in, against Tyson Fury, the lineal heavyweight champion, unbeaten, going in. The guy I thought was going to win this fight. Let's talk about who actually did. But first, remember, the opinion you should follow should be your own. Just consider this video to be a second opinion from a complete stranger online. Now, first, the fight's controversial. But in my favorites folder right now, and I know copyright hounds are all over the place, but in my favorites folder right now is a copy of the fight. I believe it's a legal copy. A YouTuber, Mr. Muscle, apparently was either at the fight or had someone at the fight taping the fight. So this video is not under Showtime's copyright. What I want you to do is to take a look at that video. You can follow along with me, right? You know, just look at it at your own convenience. This fight's one of the more major fights in the heavyweight division in quite some time. You've heard some awfully strong opinions on this fight. You know, one judge had Deontay Wilder winning the fight by several rounds. Right? You know, this fight's that rare fight, too, where they announced the scoring, and then after the scoring, you find out that the 114-110 card was mis-added up, and that the actual card should have read 114-112. So with a fight this controversial, I think it's important for people to actually see it for themselves if you haven't already. Now, let me just say this. Full disclosure, I didn't see the fight live, right? I live with four women, and I had to do some family-related stuff, as you can imagine, just when this fight is coming on, right? A lot of people care about boxing videos, but not some of the folks I live with, and that's all right. That's all right. Well, let's just say this. Floyd Mayweather is ringside. Right, I want the boxing world to look at great retired fighters like Floyd Mayweather, guys who were master technicians, as really elder statesmen of the sport. In other words, sport needs to go to these guys more often. So at the end of five rounds, Floyd Mayweather was asked who he had winning the fight, and Floyd's response was that he had Tyson Fury winning the fight five rounds to none. Understand, former heavyweight champion Lennox Lewis, another guy who I hope the sport interviews more about what's happening in the ring, especially with some of these decisions out there, right? Lennox Lewis used the word exposed in talking about Deontay Wilder, right? He thought that Tyson Fury won the fight by a wide margin. Frank Bruno, former heavyweight champion, thought that Tyson Fury won the fight by a wide margin. Now, let me just say, there are two Tyson Furies in this fight. After me looking at the fight several days after it took place, when I looked at the fight, I was aware that there was scandal. I was aware that many people thought the guys I just named, that Tyson Fury won the fight going away even though he was knocked down twice. Well, let me just say, Deontay Wilder, post-fight interviews, said that he watched the fight and said that the fight was hard to score, right? He also started talking about injuries he had in the past that may have impacted his ability to be 100% for this fight. Well, I believe there are two Tyson Furies. The fight opens up, and the Tyson Fury, who comes out, even as he puts his hands behind his back, is clearly rusty. Right? This is not Tyson Fury on his A game. Right? In the pre-fight video, and I'm sore about this, I picked Tyson Fury to win the fight. Right? Tyson Fury was the underdog. My suggested hedge was Deontay Wilder by KO. Understand, when I heard that this fight was declared a draw, probably the only person out there more upset than me in Fury's corner was probably Billy Joe Saunders, who, like me, put some money down on Tyson Fury. Well, understand, Tyson Fury comes out, he is rusty. How do you know? Deontay Wilder starts throwing right hands. Folks, that shouldn't surprise anyone. Right? He starts throwing right hands. And Tyson Fury is backing away from them. What I want you to do is to look at rounds 1 and 2 and look at how both guys are staying away from the pocket. Both guys. Fury, to me, seems unsure of his timing. In other words, this isn't the Tyson Fury who beats Vladimir Klitschko. Right? He looks like he's giving Deontay Wilder too much space. Looks like he's not engaging, my opinion, enough with Deontay Wilder. Right? Wilder comes in wearing a crown. Wilder starts the fight looking like the more confident of the two men. But what then happens in the fight is interesting, and I didn't quite expect it. What happens in the fight is you actually start to see Tyson Fury shake off the rust. So by the time the 4th and 5th rounds come about, Tyson Fury's not moving away from Deontay Wilder's right hand. Tyson Fury is actually ducking under it. Right? It's a big shift. You literally see Tyson Fury getting back to Tyson Fury. Now, all of that said, and I mean this in the most respectful way possible, the fight is a complete mismatch. It's a complete mismatch. In other words, even as I'm seeing Tyson Fury shake off the rust in the early rounds, right? He looks like a guy who hasn't been tested in the ring for quite some time. Even as he's shaking off the rust, he's winning round after round. Folks, this fight, in my opinion at least, is not a hard fight to score. Right? One guy is extremely talented. Dare I say, in my opinion, he is the best heavyweight of the post-Lennox Lewis era. Right? The other guy is in over his head. Let's talk about Wilder. I'm just going to make a few observations here in the comment section of this video. This is really a boxing community video. You can disagree with me. You can blow up my take and have your own take. Just tell me where I'm wrong if you want to. Wilder is in so far over his head that he can't fight backing up. Right? You have an unbeaten heavyweight champion who cannot fight backing up. People against Wilder are afraid to collapse the pocket on him because Wilder is that good with that straight right hand. He's what I call a fastball pitcher. I believe more guys need to collapse the pocket on him because I'm not even sure if he could throw that right hand backing up. Right? Look to me like Wilder can't fight backing up. Look to me like Wilder couldn't find Fury's body. I mean, folks, there's not even the threat of Wilder being able to hit Fury in the midsection. Keep in mind, you're fighting a guy who had to lose a lot of weight. Had to lose a lot of weight for this fight. You're fighting a guy who was inactive for more than a year, who then came back and who fought two guys in the witness protection program. Right? A guy who's fighting himself back into shape. A guy who jumped in when Wilder's fight against Anthony Joshua didn't go forward. Can I say Anthony Joshua's name in this video? Right? You're fighting a guy who really is a replacement. Right? We know Fury's the lineal heavyweight champion. We know he deserved the bout. But the politics of boxing had him on the outside. So one would think that if Wilder was a very highly skilled technician type, one of the things Wilder would do would be to hit Fury in the body. Test his stamina, right? A guy can look good, but you hit him in the body a few times, and if a guy lacks stamina, that's going to take whatever fight he had out of him. Folks, there's no threat in this fight of hardcore body punching from Deontay Wilder. Right? Wilder just doesn't have the offensive tools to really work over a guy's body. The big problem with Wilder is he's a pot shotter. There's the straight right hand. He also has a left hook that he could throw to the body, but the problem is when you know these punches are coming, you can defend yourself against them. So as you watch the film, just look, occasionally Fury will throw jabs to Wilder's body. Right? Now keep in mind, this is a Fury who is cautious early in the fight. I know Fury puts his hands behind his back early in the fight, but he's far away from Wilder. He's not doing that in the middle of a flurry. He's not doing that in the pocket. Fury and Wilder are both slightly out of the pocket. Right? Fury looks like he is figuring out distance. Well, even while Fury is rusty, Wilder just doesn't have the skill set to collapse the pocket and to start to work over the guy's body. What I want people to do is to compare and contrast this fight with Mike Tyson against Brian Nielsen. That fight's up on YouTube. Mike Tyson decides from the opening bell, I'm going to take away this guy's body. Right? Nielsen, big puncher, but flabby. Right? Bigger puncher than Tyson Fury. Look at his KO ratio. But flabby. Can't do much when Tyson attacks his body. Here you have Tyson Fury, who looks like he lost a lot of weight, who doesn't have a lot of muscle tone. And Wilder to the body isn't even really a possibility. I saw Wilder landed a couple of left hands to the body and stuff like that, but let's just say hardly any body attack. Let me say this too. In terms of making adjustments, Wilder just can't make the adjustment. He's hardwired. So, you'll notice later in this fight, right? Wilder's throwing right hands and Tyson Fury literally just ducks, right? Just ducks under them. Now, a guy who makes adjustments after seeing Tyson Fury duck several times under the right hand would think like he's throwing the right hand. So then Fury is going to duck because that's what the guy's been doing. Then you know where Fury's going to be because Fury's ducking right in front of you. So at that point, a guy who makes adjustments could say to himself, okay, I'm going to throw a left hook. I'm going to fake the right hand. Then I'm going to come in with the left hook. Or If I'm the bronze bomber with an A-plus straight right hand, I'm going to fake the right hand, have the guy bend over to the side as Fury was doing. Fury would literally turn, have his head this way, right? Have his head pointed toward Wilder's left hand and would bend that way. I was expecting Wilder to fake the right hand. This is an adjustment. Fake the right hand. The guy bends. He's right there. Then load up and throw the real right hand while the guy is bent over and stuff like that. Wilder's just not a guy who makes adjustments. The game plan in the first round was the game plan in the 12th round. We'll talk about that 12th round. Let me say this too. You're in the ring with a guy who doesn't have your punching power, at least not your best punching power, right? That's the other problem with Wilder. They're heavy punchers who hit you with both hands. Nigel Benn, right? Mike Tyson. Where, you know, you show up, you say, I'm going to avoid Mike Tyson's right hand. Then, oh, here's the left hook. I'm knocked out, right? You know the heavy puncher type guy. Right? Golovkin. You show up, you say, hey, I'm gonna look over here. Then the guy clobbers you over here and it's all over, right? Julio Cesar Chavez, the father, not the son. Right? He gets inside. You couldn't say, hey, let me tie up his right hand. Guy would take you out with his left hand, right? Just ask Roger Mayweather. Well, let me just say here, Wilder has an A-plus right hand. A-plus. But take away that right hand, and it has to be a straight right hand. It's A-plus from distance. Take away that right hand from distance. And is Wilder even a puncher? Right? Doesn't really have that knockout power with his left. I have seen films. There are a couple of knockouts here online of Wilder finishing a guy with his left hand. But usually that's after he's softened you up with some right hands, right? Well, let me say, Wilder's so one-handed that, folks, in this fight, he can't even land left jabs. That's how beaten he is. You're watching the fight, he can't land the right power punch. He can't even hit Fury with left jabs. So you have to ask yourself, given Wilder's style, which is heavily reliant on knockouts, heavily reliant, how does a guy like this win the slow rounds where neither guy hits the canvas, where it's not about whether you staggered the other guy, but it's about whether you outboxed the other guy? Understand, every slow round in this fight, in my opinion, every slow round in this fight, and there are only two rounds where Fury hits the canvas, right? Every slow round in this fight, I would give to Tyson Fury. If you're feeling charitable, you could call a slow round a draw. I don't see how you get to the point where you're giving any of the slow rounds to Deontay Wilder. In other words, Fury at times is taunting Wilder, as you can imagine. Has his hands behind his back several times in this fight. Several. Right? Okay, I could see a judge saying, you know what, Fury, who's not high volume. He's not. I could see a judge saying, okay, Fury was, you know, Fury obviously was in control of the round, but he didn't throw enough punches. By the way, I disagree with that philosophy. I'm someone who gave Ali the first round of that first fight against Sonny Liston, even though he hardly throws punches. But judges who want to see punches landed could penalize a fighter. Right? Roy Jones didn't win the gold medal in 1988 because Roy Jones at times is taunting his opponent. Right? The fans know Jones is in total control. I could see some judges saying, you know, he's taunting him, he's not hitting him. This is boxing. I'm not going to give him credit. Okay, fine. But let's just say, apart from the 9th and 12th rounds, you'd be hard-pressed to give any of these rounds, any of them, to Deontay Wilder. As I said, he's not landing a jab. He's not landing a jab. He's not landing a right hand. So in the comment section here, if you feel Wilder won this fight, or if you feel that this fight was legitimately a draw, and I'm going to put up a poll here online in my community section here after I do this video, right? Asking who won this fight, right? If you feel Wilder won the fight or earned the draw, tell us exactly what he is doing in those rounds where he's not landing right hands and he's not landing a jab, because he's certainly not landing body shots. Let me say, too, this is one of those fights where I looked at the CompuBox numbers before making this video, and I thought, you know what? I'm not even going to refer to these, because these look questionable to me, right? I just didn't see the punches landed that the CompuBox numbers suggest. Let me go further, too. You know, I criticized Joe Joyce here in an earlier video against Joe Hanks, and Joe Joyce closed the show. He's still unbeaten. He got a first-round KO. You can't get an earlier KO than a first-round KO. I congratulate him. But in that video, I pointed out that, in my opinion, Joe Joyce fights too tall. Right? I like heavyweights like Mike Tyson, where Tyson could come in a crouch, right? You know, he's not always standing up. There are times where Tyson gets low, bends his knees, right? Comes in and can get low and then can spring up on you, right? So if you don't have that Larry Holmes level jab, if you can't bludgeon the guy while standing up, I'd like to see some upper body movement. I'd like to see a guy get low, so when he throws a straight punch, it's a body shot. To me, Deontay Wilder fights too tall. Right? In other words, you know it's a right hand up top. When he throws the left hook, you know more times than not, it's going to be up top. The fact that Fury's able to duck under his right hand tells you that Wilder was too predictable. Let's talk about the 9th round, right? I gave, obviously, the 9th round to Deontay Wilder. What I want people to do in looking at that knockdown is to see that Fury actually bends, but he bends almost looking at Wilder, right? He's right by the ropes. That's important. And rather than bend toward Wilder's left, as he was to dodge the right hand, he bends straight down, gets caught with a Wilder shot, goes down. Now, what's interesting with that 9th round knockdown is that Fury gets up off the canvas, is alert. I mean completely alert. I can't say that about the 12th round. But in the 9th round, Fury gets caught. He goes down, right? At this point, and I'm serious about this, both guys would have to have known that Wilder's heavyweight belt hung in the balance, that unless something dramatic happened in the fight, Fury was going to leave the ring with not just the lineal heavyweight championship that he bought in, but also with a WBC heavyweight crown. So Fury goes down. Legitimate knockdown, not a slip. He's bending forward. Wilder hits him with what else? A right hand. Right? Fury goes down. But when Fury gets up, he's so alert that as the ref talks to him, he puts his hands, he taps the ref on the shoulders. Right? There is no doubt that Fury is, let's say, 100%. Or as 100% as you can be in the ninth round of a heavyweight title fight. Now, by the end of the round, right? Understand, the round's 3 minutes. By the end of the round, Fury is back to mocking Wilder. Fury has shaken off the knockdown, right? At the very end of the round, Fury tries to steer down Wilder. Wilder, at the end of the round, turns and walks to his corner. Fury's trying to make eye contact with him. Right? You get the feeling Fury is more embarrassed by the ninth round knockdown than he is hurt. Well, let's talk about the 12th round knockdown, because I think that that was the most surprising part of the fight for me. I knew about the 12th round knockdown before I saw the film, right? So I'm there watching the thing. I thought, okay, well, you know, I knew Fury had to hold on at times in the round. So I was expecting Fury to get drilled, Fury to get up, and Fury to hold on, like Dylan White held on in the closing seconds against Joseph Parker, right? You've just been in a car crash. You've done the work to win the fight. You're going to do whatever it takes to make it to the closing bell. That's what I thought I was going to see. You know what causes that knockdown in the 12th round? Folks, the video's in my favorites folder here. It's Tyson Fury in control of a fight. Keep in mind, even with these judges, Fury has the fight in hand going into the 12th round, right? The judge that has the fight a draw, just understand, has Fury ahead by 2 points going into the last round, right? Fury has the fight. Fury lands a pretty good right hand on Deontay Wilder, right? One of the better punches of the fight. He lands the right hand. I believe the fact that he lands the right hand causes him to relax a little bit and lose focus. Because after he lands the right hand, Fury stays in the pocket. He just stands there. Right? You know, they have a phrase, admiring your work. Well, Fury lands the right hand, then he takes the moment to, like, wipe his brow or something. And it's while he is lingering in the pocket after landing a good punch that Wilder comes with a hellacious right hand and a left hook after it. Right? The right hand drops Fury. As Fury's headed to the canvas, the left hook accentuates Fury to the canvas, right? I'll say this. Fury barely gets back up. He's in deep trouble the next 15 seconds after he gets up. Deep trouble. Folks, he then starts to control the action. This is in the round where he gets drilled and dropped. This is in the 12th round. I don't know what's going on with British fighters. I don't know why James DeGale is hanging around Badu Jack in the 12th round of a fight he's won, so Badu Jack gets a draw. I have no idea why Tyson Fury was insistent on being on his front foot in the 12th round of a fight that he was winning handily, right? The judges had it much closer, obviously, than the fans did at the arena. The judges had it much closer than it should have been. That knockdown gets Deontay Wilder the draw, right? Realistically, Tyson Fury should have been up by several rounds, 6-7 rounds at that point, if not more, right? Fury has himself to blame You're fighting a guy who can't fight inside. That's another problem with Deontay Wilder. Can't fight inside. Can't hit you with a jab. Right? Can't even hit you with a body shot. Is just trying to land a big straight right hand, especially late in the fight in the 12th round, when Wilder had to have known that his title was leaving him. Now, I need for Fury to go back, and I need for Fury to watch the last round of Julio Cesar Chavez against the great Pernell Whitaker. Right? Understand, Chavez had gotten a very late closing seconds KO over Whitaker's buddy, Meldrick Taylor. So in the 12th round of that Chavez-Pernell Whitaker fight, there's a moment where Chavez is trying to, you know, get Whitaker to fight him. And Whitaker, who has the fight won, waves at him. It's like, you gotta be kidding me. This fight is over. By the way, those judges call that fight a draw. I saw that fight in Mexico. Right? Only brother in the building. And I'm telling you, several people came up to me after that fight and said, lo siento. I'm sorry. You know, they knew the scoring was ridiculous. Well, here, Tyson Fury, to take the title, only has to lose the 12th round 10-9. Right? In other words, God doesn't even need the round. Right? As Deontay Wilder is lingering outside, Wilder can't cut off the ring, you know that. So as Wilder's lingering outside, all Fury had to do, and Fury has an excellent jab, is wave at him. Right? Wave at it. Back away. Right? Smile like Pernell did. Let the guy know, look, dude, this fight's over. Folks could boo me all they want. Right? Do what Oscar De La Hoya did. He got penalized by the judges for it in the closing rounds against Felix Trinidad. Stay outside. Right? Let the other guy know, look, I feel I have this in the bank. Instead, Fury is throwing good right hands and lingering around the pocket. Folks, it came this close to costing him everything. Understand, despite the great performance, right? Had Fury not gotten up, he would have lost this fight. I'm telling you, there is no way on God's green earth Deontay Wilder, after seeing how the matchup actually played out, would ever give Tyson Fury a rematch if he won this fight by stoppage. Let me say, Anthony Joshua wanted no part of Tyson Fury before this fight. Right? Eddie Hearn and he were saying, hey, we want to fight Wilder. In fact, Joshua was so ridiculous. Joshua started openly saying things like, yeah, you know, I hope Wilder wins. I need for Wilder to win. The Joshua people have to know a fight with Fury, especially the Fury who shakes off some rust and moves closer to being Tyson Fury in the middle rounds, fifth, sixth, seventh rounds, right? They have to know that Joshua has no shot on him. Right? If Joshua is savvy, he'll realize, I need to fight Fury soon. Because you give Tyson Fury a couple more fights. If Tyson Fury gets back to being prime Tyson Fury, then even mismatches like his fight against Deontay Wilder, which was so controversial, that Wilder sanctioning body, think about it, after first telling us that the scoring was within the zone of uncertainty in boxing, right? Even the WBC had to order a rematch. You know why? It's because fans looked at the film and they said, this dude was dominating. Right? I mean, understand, the narrative of the fight sounds closer than the actual fight. You hear from friends, Yeah, Tyson Fury got knocked down twice. And then you're thinking to yourself, well, man, that had to be a competitive fight. Dude's getting knocked down in two different rounds, and, you know, everyone's wondering how he gets up after the second knockdown. Sounds like Deontay Wilder made this real competitive. Then you see the fight and you realize, nah, man, this wasn't competitive. It's so one-sided, think about it, even with a draw. People were upset, and Wilder's sanctioning body had to say, all right, we'll call for an immediate rematch. This is with big money fights out there. Anthony Joshua, right? Big money fights out there. They said, hey, we need to see an immediate rematch. I'll just tell you, Deontay Wilder's in a lot of trouble if that rematch ever takes place. Right? His best chance to stop Fury may have been in the very early rounds, apart from the 12th round, when Fury's hurt and he gets off the canvas, right? He's badly hurt those first 15 seconds. He looks like Joshua against Klitschko when he gets off the canvas. But other than that 12th round, the best shot Deontay Wilder may have had of beating Tyson Fury might have been the first three rounds of the fight. Because you can tell Fury is not sure of himself. He's winning the rounds, but you can tell he's trying to figure out the angles, and the angles are hard to read on Wilder because Wilder likes to throw punches from so far away. You allow Tyson Fury to shake off more rust, and you're going to get a qualitatively better Tyson Fury. Right? If I'm the Deontay Wilder people, I'm like, hey, let's have the fight in February. Let's have the fight in March. Right? I don't want the fight in July or August or September. I don't want Tyson Fury saying, hey, Joe Joyce, let's fool around again. Hell, let me get Dylan White in here. Look. Let me get Kubrat Pulev in here. You know, let me get other guys in here so I could shake off this rust. Right? I'm just telling you, the heavyweight division needs to be put on notice. I don't think any of these big clunky guys beats Tyson Fury. In my opinion, the guys who would have a shot on Tyson Fury are the more mobile type guys, like Alexander Usyk, right? Fury's not trying to load up on punches here, right? You need a guy who can move with him. Understand, Fury, who doesn't look like he has fast hand speed in this fight, just fights much faster than Deontay Wilder. You notice Fury's doing feints and stuff. In the space between punches, Fury's just doing more. You notice, too, Fury's reflexes are faster, not his hand speed, but his reflexes are faster. And you notice he's just doing more things, more feints and stuff like that. Deontay Wilder can't fight at that speed. I believe Alexander Usyk, who beat Joe Joyce in the World Series of Boxing years ago, I think it's a cruiserweight type guy who would give Tyson Fury more problems than Deontay Wilder. Wilder's only chance of beating Tyson Fury is by stoppage. And I know that sounds odd after he just got a draw. I did not see the slow round that Deontay Wilder won. If you did, share that information with us in the comment section of this video. So to sum up, maybe it's sour grapes. I lost on both sides of this play. I thought Fury would win this fight by several rounds. By the way, I still think he did, but this is boxing, right? By the way, for the record, years ago, I had a bet on Lennox Lewis. He was fighting Evander Holyfield. I'm not kidding. Toward the end of that fight, Lewis raises his hands. Look at the tape. He raises his hands and he shakes his hands. I had the bet with a friend. I was then on the phone with another friend, just gonna talk smack, say, yeah, I told you guys, Lennox Lewis. And it was while I was on the phone talking smack that they called that fight a draw, right? This is boxing. Sometimes, even when you think you win, the judges don't agree. But I want to know what you think. Who won this fight? Was it close? Was the scorecard that had Deontay Wilder winning the fight by several rounds credible? Let us know in the comment section of this video, and be careful. This is a public forum, right? You need to think about defamation law. So rather than say, this judge is a bum, what you want to do is say, in my opinion, this judge is a bum. In other words, make it an opinion, not a statement of fact. That's how I see it. Thanks for stopping by.